Okay, so I'm going to talk about these knuckle dusters that I picked up on the street. Actually, not on the street, in Japan, in Yokohama, in Chinatown. And this was only... Shit, how much is this? No, I tell a lie. So I actually got these at a military store in Tokyo, in Akabane. And it was only... Shit, how much was it? 1,000 something yen, which is like, you know, 12, 13 bucks, US or Australian, whatever you want to, you know, do your own calculation. Anyway, it's quite cheap. They're heavy, they do the job, okay, I'll put it that way. They're big enough to fit me, okay, I'm a 6'4", 6'5", whatever, 105 kilo guy that doesn't have really small hands, as you might be able to see. So, you know, to find a set that fit me well enough or perfectly was just about impossible, but I found one at this shop that I went to. In Chinatown, in Yokohama, they had none that fit me. They have some that are belt buckles and they can be taken off and being used. The problem with that is they don't actually sit right because they got the belt buckle bits and everything. So I think if you buy them, you're a fucking idiot anyway. But now, there's a couple of ways you can use this. If you've ever actually punched with them, sometimes you can hurt yourself doing it. So you've got to know how to put them on and use them properly. Okay, so I'm going to try and get a bit of a different angle just to show you. Okay, so what I want to do, basic first standard grip, I guess you call it, is putting your hands in like so. Okay, your two fingers, wrap this one around. This one sits a little bit differently depending on how big this finger is. Okay, this pinky finger. Now, I definitely don't want to put it on there because when you go and smash it, the impact can really hurt you. Okay, so I usually just hold it around like that. It's a little bit different to a normal fist, but I haven't got really big fat fingers. Okay. But I've still got big hands, so I need something like this either way, okay? So that's one way, okay? Some people like to hold it and push it and use it as a control weapon, even doing this sort of thing where, how was it? I was showing one way of holding it like this, okay? And using it like a control device or an impact weapon, but not as such like a punching and smashing weapon, not as violently, I guess. I don't see the point in this. This is just trying to be tricky and you know, some ninja guys that were you know, thinking they can do locks with this sort of thing, whatever. If they got their packet of fucking fairy dust with them, it should work too. But anyways, this thing, if you have it on this end, you can see they're not sharp, but if you ever smack someone in the head, you'll know that even just the sharpness, if you're going to call it that, the edge or the shape of your fist can cut someone's cheek, okay, very, very easily, or the jaw or whatever else. So these can do the exact same thing. And the reason you'd use these for women or for smaller guys in a bit of a ghetto neighborhood or whatever, you know, a lot of people are going to disagree with having these, and only thugs would wear them and so forth and so on. But, you know, having said that, you know, I carry all sorts of things on me because of where I live and the job that I do, so there you go. Now, the other way of holding this is putting it on a reverse way, like that, because it's flattened, and some people will prefer this, okay? And, you know, you can hold it like so, and your other fingers can fit in. I'll just show you from this angle as well, okay? You just put your fingers through the end of it, like this, and like that. Okay, so it's sitting there, and you've got this bit to smack with. So if you smack someone in the forehead, I can see a pretty good knockout coming out of that. Okay, but yeah, if depending on the size and shape of your hand, this might sit better than the standard grip way like that. This one's a little bit loose on me because, as you can see, they're quite big compared to my hand. Okay. But yeah, again, having said that, I've got a big hand, so I needed a bigger size. I think these are banned in Australia. I know you can. One of my students here in Japan comes to my Shinjuku class. He got arrested a couple of years ago for carrying these on him. But I mean, look, he's a small, skinny guy, you know, in a real ghetto area. There's heaps and heaps of mafia around. If he needed to make a quick escape and just, you know, I guess you could call this a one-hit wonder weapon because you might be able to smack someone and really do some damage just compared to your own hand, because if you don't know how to punch properly, obviously you're going to fuck your own hand and even your wrist. And that's why we say hitting with your palms is always best. But yeah, the knuckle duster can really... You can use a hammer fist. You can hear how solid that is, other than just the actual punch itself. Talking about control devices and all that sort of thing, like some of these other things I see that are less lethal weapons for law enforcement, I think are a bit bit of bullshit, really. But you know, if you want to call this a thug's weapon, so be it. I'm not bothered by that. I think that anyone carrying with them has a reason to. You know, it's not because they're crazy or psychotic or whatever, but sometimes there's need for it. So that's the knuckle duster, and I've seen these being homemade before too. I've seen some very good versions of homemade ones. We've seen some really shitty ones too. I've seen ones in Thailand that you squeeze. They had like this thing on a knife come out. It's just insane. They've got these other ones that you hold onto here, and they've got two knives, or they've got a knife coming out here. There's some really, really insane stuff that you can get out there. Just on the streets of Bangkok, where was that? Sukhumvit or Siam, I can't remember. But it was a couple of years ago now. But yeah, there's some insane stuff. But anyway, that's the knuckle duster, and that's basics in how to use it. So good luck.